A third important instruction that the pencil maker gave the pencil was, unless you go through sharpening, what is within you will not come out. The pencil has to go through painful sharpening before the sharp lead comes out and makes an impact. Ladies and gentlemen, similarly in life, unless we go through painful sharpening, the best things within will never come out. As they say, no pains, no gains. I read a very amazing Sanskrit verse once, which spoke about the five qualities that a student must have. In fact, each of us is a student in our life. And this is why we should possess and try to cultivate these five qualities. KAK CHESTA BAKO DHYANAM SHWAN NIDRA TATHAIVACHA ALPAHARI GRIHTYAAGI VIDYARTHI PANCHALAKSHANAM VIDYARTHI. Vidya means knowledge. Arthi means one who desires knowledge. VIDYARTHI, one who desires knowledge. All of us should possess PANCHALAKSHANAM, these five characteristic features and qualities. The first one, KAKA CHESTA. KAKA means a crow, and CHESTA means effort. KAKA CHESTA means the effort of a crow. All of us in our childhood read the story of a crow who was extremely thirsty and was flying around looking for some water. The crow found a pitcher of water as the crow landed itself on the rim of the pitcher and looked inside at the contents. He found there was water, but the water was at the very bottom of the pitcher and there was no way that the crow could drink water by putting its beak inside. The crow started thinking, what should be done? And it came across a brilliant idea. It started flying around and picking up in its beak tiny pebbles and putting them inside the pitcher. Pebble by pebble by pebble, the crow kept working hard until the level of the water rose way up to the rim of the pitcher and the crow quenched its thirst. KAKA CHESTA refers to the patient hard work and the effort of the crow. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, if we have to work on our lives, if we have to truly bring what is within outside, we have to go through some painful sharpening of KAKA CHESTA, hard work. And don't they say that the only place where success comes before work is in the dictionary? That's because S comes before W. The second quality of a Vidyarthi is BAKO DHYANAM. BAKO DHYANAM means the focus, the intense focus of a crane. When one looks at the crane standing on one leg, completely focused into the waters, the crane with one pointed attention is looking at the waters as the fishes are swimming inside the waters. The crane will allow the tiny, the small fish to swim around and not be satisfied with them. It'll allow the fishes, the small fishes, to go around and swim around. The crane will focus and wait for the big fish to come. If the crane settles with the small fish, it'll lose the big fish. And if the crane wants the big fish, it has to allow the small fish to pass by and go around. Similarly in life, when you want to focus on what is important, we should allow the small things to pass by. We shouldn't be distracted by the little things. Sometimes there'll be interpersonal issues and conflicts. Sometimes there'll be some health crises. Sometimes there might be a financial crisis. So many things keep happening in life. Let the small things pass by and focus on what's important. The third quality of a student or a vidyarthi is shwan nidra. Shwan means a dog and nidra means sleep. Shwan nidra means the sleep of a dog, or to be more precise, the alertness of a dog. All of us have seen, actually, when a dog is sleeping, although the eyes are closed, the dog is very alert to the surroundings around it. Even if there's a little sound, or even if someone just walks in very, very slowly, the dog will immediately open its eyes. All those who want knowledge in their lives and want to pursue something that's meaningful in life have to practice the quality of alertness. Although we may be eyes closed doing, not literally, but doing what we are doing in our lives, we shouldn't miss out on being alert to the world around us. There's a lot to learn in the world from people, from objects, from situations, from surroundings. We'll only learn when we are alert. The fourth quality that a vidyarthi must possess is alpahari. Ahar in Sanskrit means food, and alpa means less. So literally, alpahari means that a vidyarthi or one seeking knowledge should eat less. Now, this is not what has been implied by this word, though. We have varieties of ahar. Like, for example, for our tongue, we have food. That's the ahar. For our ears, we have sound. That's the ahar. Music, talks. For our eyes, sights, people, beautiful panoramic scenery is the ahar. So for each of our senses, there is ahar. And when this verse says that a vidyarthi should be alpahari, it means we should be very careful of what inputs we give to our senses. Because whatever inputs we give to our senses actually go and make a very deep, indelible impression on our psyche, on our inner systems. In Sanskrit, that is called sanskar. Sanskar means that indelible impression that sensory inputs leave on our minds. I'll tell you, we give so many inputs through our senses and they leave a very indelible mark, sometimes unerasable mark, on our consciousness and our minds. Therefore, when we talk about alpahari, it means we should be very careful to choose those sensory inputs which are of value and those things that we want our mind space to be filled with. Do not subject yourselves to unwanted things in the world around which will go and occupy your precious mind space, which should not be taken by unwanted, less valuable and less priority things. Your mind space is meant and reserved for the most important and valuable things. The fifth thing, or the fifth quality that a vidyarthi must possess is grihatyagi. Griha means home, tyagi means to give up, leave. In the ancient Eastern world of India, students would leave their home at early age and go to study under their teachers or gurus in the school which was called Gurukul. Grihatyagi means leaving home to go and go in pursuit of knowledge. In its real implied sense, grihatyagi doesn't mean leaving home. It means leaving our comfort zone. If we are living in our comfort zone, griha or home represents comfort zone. So if we are going to live in our comfort zone, there's no question of pursuing that which is of true value. Therefore, grihatyagi refers to coming out of our comfort zone, which is what no pains, no gains means. And thus, these five qualities, KAK CHESTA, the effort of a crow, BAKO DHYANAM, the focus of a crane, SHWAN NIDRA, the alertness of a dog, ALPAHARI, giving the right inputs to our senses, and GRIHTYAAGI, coming out of the comfort zone, are painful, ladies and gentlemen. But no pains, no gains. And thus, the third thing that the pencil maker told the pencil was, you will have to go through some painful sharpening before what is important, the lead, comes out. Thank you.